Distinguished special guests, professional consultants, respected members, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Thank you very much. You know, after a hard day, getting a very energetic good evening is a little difficult, but we got it. So can we try it once again? Yeah? So good evening, everybody. Love it. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Everest Rodriguez, and I am going to be your anchor during the evening. First of all, we at CREDAI MCHI have been implementing all the rules and regulations as per the COVID-19 related guidelines laid by the government. And for this event, we have taken necessary precautions and restricted to a gathering of 50 members. I extend a warm and hearty welcome to all of you on this momentous occasion of the inauguration ceremony of the two units, that is CREDAI MCHI Palghar Boisar unit and CREDAI MCHI Bhiwandi unit. The launch of CREDAI MCHI mobile app and launch of members guidance cell are going to be the highlight of today. CREDAI MCHI is a proud association of around 1,800 real estate developers who collectively account for 80% of the organized development in Mumbai and MMR and is known for providing housing solutions to Mumbaikars. Our unity and resilience to face it all bravely makes us the most sought-after association. No wonder CREDAI MCHI has emerged as the ultimate voice of real estate industry. So I think this deserves another huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for each one of us. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to begin the program, and we would request you all to please stand for the national anthem.
जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उज्जल जलधि तरंगा
तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ मागे
गाए तब जय दाता जय जय मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. Before we begin, we would like to acknowledge and thank some of the dignitaries who are present here, who are on the way. We would like to thank them for their help, assistance, and guidance. We would like to say a big thank you to our past presidents, Mr. Vyomesh Shah, Mr. Praveen Doshi, Mr. Paras Gundecha, Mr. Mayur Shah. A big thank you also to Mr. Nayan Shah, immediate past president, Mr. Shrikant Shitole, President KDU, Mr. Asit Shah, President Meera Virar, Mr. Vijay Lakhani, President Navi Mumbai, and Mr. Jitendra Mehta, incoming President Thane. To start off this evening, ladies and gentlemen, we would like to invite the president of CREDAI MCHI, Mr. Deepak Goradia, to join us on stage to say a few words to give us his welcoming address. Please get your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as Mr. Goradia joins us on stage.
Thank you. Good evening, all members. This is the first time after the second wave in person we are meeting. Very happy to see everyone in person after a very, very long time. Though with keeping the norms with the COVID, we have hope that we continue with this trend at least once in a month, our managing committee, and whenever we have opportunity, we would be happy to meet one-to-one. The interaction on Zoom, interaction in person, offline and online, there's a lot of difference. So happy to see everyone in person. Thank you very much all for joining today. I'm happy, very, very happy and glad to announce the opening of two units of Kerala MCHI. One unit, the unit Kerala MCHI Palghar unit, Palghar Boisar unit, and Kerala MCHI Bhiwandi unit. I welcome the team of Kerala MCHI Palghar Boisar unit and Bhiwandi unit today, who's with us, and we are happy to start with a part of the family of Kerala MCHI. Our task owner, Shailesh Puranik, he has worked continuously since last couple of weeks or months and continuously meeting the new unit point of view, both the association members, and with that continuous follow-up and the persuasion, we have been able to expand Kerala MCHI in the area where members' point of view, the association really works for the purpose of benefit of the members and for the improvement and the ease of doing business, expanding the business in a better way, creating network, and developing the rapport individually, developing the rapport and liaising with the government. This association expansion is definitely in MMR area, is a part of the Kerala MCHI. Welcome you all, both of you. The overall, what we expect that being an association, it's not a collective strength of working together. Working as an association, working individually, liaising individually for the government department, or liaising collectively, makes a lot of strength. We work, we grow, and we expand our business in a big way. As a Kerala MCHI family, the Kerala MCHI assure you both the units that wherever you have an urban local body there in Bhiwandi, in Palghar, in Boisar, all urban local body now comes under unified DCPR. The issues concerned with unified DCPR, issues concerned with the market, issues concerned with the increasing the volume of market, we will be all working together. Wherever you have a support, require support at any level, at the state level, urban local body level, or at the central government level, where not only environment issue, the issues with finance ministry, issues, we will all work together and try to resolve for the benefit of all the members, and that will definitely be a big way where with your strength we will definitely do a better job. So you rest assured that being a Kerala MCHI, whatever support you require at the state level and all, we are there to support with you. Welcome you all, and let's work together and grow the business with a better success. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to take it forward, we would like to invite Shri Shailesh Puranik, Joint Secretary Kerala MCHI, to this inauguration ceremony of the two units. Please get your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as Mr. Puranik joins us on stage.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. So when our President Deepak Bhai gave me this responsibility that we intend to find and get new units on board, I was really honored. I must thank Deepak Bhai to give me this responsibility. And when I started meeting people after discussing with Deepak Bhai and which all areas that we can expand. And the more and more I met people, it's an experience I must share that each area that we go to, I go to, each new developer I meet, the problems remain same, the issues remain same. The need to come together collectively and handle issues is more and more, becoming more and more important these days. And issues are no longer restricted to the local bodies, as Deepak Bhai was saying. It's also the issues concerning and due to the state issues or state level jurisdiction, rules, regulation, and also due to central laws and legislations like GST and etc. And that's why it is very, very important that we come together collectively. The time has come that we work jointly, not only at the urban local body level, but at state level, where CREDAI MCHI will play a major role, and also at the central level, where CREDAI National will play a major role. Whatever meetings we have had with both these units and a couple of other units, this is the main thing that we have been discussing. When you come together, that is one answer to the solution. When you come together under the CREDAI National umbrella, you get that brand which is required, which will open doors for all of us, which would be very, very difficult. And when we started meeting, for example, for Boisar Palghar, the Tarapur issue came up, and then we immediately, of course, met together and kind of put forward our issues. But that is just the beginning. There are so many things that we can do together. Same is true with Bhiwandi. When we were having the first meeting in Bhiwandi, the kind of issues that they were deliberating upon, the issue of infrastructure, the issue of multiple jurisdiction, the issue of some problems not getting solved or even attended to at state level, etc., etc. I think everything remains same. And that's why this idea of our president, this idea of CREDAI National to form more and more units, get more on member, more members under our fold, so that collectively we represent not only at urban bodies, but even at national level. And with that thought, let us inaugurate these two units and welcome them to the fold of CREDAI MCHI. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Before we move on to the next section, which is the highlight of the evening, you know, I would like to do a quick exercise with all of us. You know, they say that a team, yeah, when we work together as a team, anything is possible. You can move mountains, you can bring rain. You can bring rain. So I'm going to demonstrate that when we work together as a team, we can bring rain over here. Do you all believe that you can bring rain? You got to say loud yes for this one. Do you believe? Yeah, I like that. Very nice. I cued you for that. All right, so this is how it works. Yeah, and I need everybody to participate in this one. Yeah, each and every one of you. When I show you one finger, you've got to tap one finger against the palm of the other hand. When I show you two fingers, you go with two. Three fingers, you go with three. Four fingers, you go with four. And five fingers, you go with the full hand. All right? So, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to bring rain over here. So, are you ready? Yeah. Okay. So, let's start with one finger. Two. Let's go with three. Four. Five. Again, four. Three. Two. Three again. Four, and a five once again. Ladies and gentlemen, did it sound like rain? Yeah. Yes, it did. And it was only possible because we all worked together as a team. That's what CREDAI MCHI is all about. Teamwork, working together as a team. And this team is expanding, and we are handing over the baton to the other part of the team. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to this most important part of the evening. As I said, we would like to request the president of CREDAI MCHI, Sri Deepak Goradia, to join us on stage. And we would also request Mr. Rajesh Mehta, president, Palghar Boisar unit, to join us on stage. Please get your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as we have the dignitaries joining us on stage. Okay, so now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment that we have been waiting for. We will witness this moment that we have been waiting for, the historic baton handover. And may I request Monica to do the honors of handing over the baton to Mr. Deepak Goradia to be handed over to Mr. Rajesh Mehta. A three, a two, and a one. Please go ahead. A huge congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. And that's not all. We would also request Mr. Goradia to hand over the membership certificate to Mr. Mehta. Congratulations to you. And Mr. Mehta, I would request you to stay back with us. A big thank you to Mr. Goradia for joining us, sir, on stage. It's time to hear from the President, Palghar Boisar, Sri Rajesh Mehta, about his vision, his thoughts on how to take forward the real estate industry in his region. Mr. Mehta, over to you, sir.
Good evening. First of all, thank you everyone for providing us a platform of CREDAI MCHI to represent the area of Palghar Boisar. Palghar Boisar is an upcoming destination with various infrastructure projects like bullet train station in Boisar, Vadodara Expressway, and Vadhavan Port. And even SIDCO is coming up with a huge project of 900 acres layout. We would like to thank specifically to Deepak Bhai, Pritam, Sailesh Bhai, Rikav, and Nishant Patil for taking the initiative and inspiring us to make a CREDAI MCHI Palghar Boisar. This platform will help us in progress of the overall development of our region and bring unity among our members. All our founding members will work towards making this unit an active and productive unit, which will continue working on the ethos and vision of CREDAI MCHI. Thank you. Thank you.
So may I request the entire managing committee of CREDAI MCHI Palghar Boisar unit to join us on stage. I would like to invite Mr. Deepak Goradia, Mr. Shailesh Puranik, and Mr. Boman Irani on stage. Mr. Fanil Shah, Vice President, Mr. Prashant Khandelwal, Secretary, Mr. Nimish Pasad, Treasurer, Mr. Rajesh Bapna, Member, Mr. Dinesh Dubey, a member, Shantanu Vichare, Mr. Akshay Sankhe, Mr. Samir Patel, Mr. Parikshit Dandekar, and Mr. Pawan Singh. Thank you very much, gentlemen. May I request Mr. Boman Irani to please stay back with us on stage. I'm sorry I give you the exercise of going and coming back again. Thank you very much, sir. So we have with us on stage Sri Boman Irani, President-elect, CREDAI MCHI. We would like to invite on stage Mr. K.K. Duraj, President of CREDAI MCHI Bhiwandi. Please get your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so at the count of three, sir, one, a two, and a three. The handing over of the baton. And we would also request Mr. Irani to hand over the membership certificate to Mr. K.K. Doraj, the president of CREDA MCHI Bhiwandi. Thank you and congratulations. Thank you, Mr. Irani. And Mr. Doraj, over to you, sir.
Good evening, everybody. First, I would like to thank the MCHI Thana unit, jinhone initiate kiya aur humko support kiya today formation of Bhiwandi CREDA MCHI. Especially मैं thanks बोलना चाहूँगा शैलेश सर को और दीपक सर को, जिन्होंने इस Bhiwandi units को formation करने के लिए हम लोगों को काफ़ी encourage किया और हमने आज ये platform हमको दिया. अब Bhiwandi जो है वो न्यू डेवलप एरिया है, जो थाने के इतना नज़दीक होने के बाद भी कुछ अनसर्टन रीज़न की वजह से पिछड़ा हुआ था. बिकॉज कुछ बायलॉस थे जिसकी वजह से Bhiwandi हमेशा जो है वो इलीगल कंस्ट्रक्शन और अदर्स वे में रहा, अनडेवलप सिटी रहा और सेल्फ सस्टेन्ड सिटी रहा. ना ट्रांसपोर्टेशन के नाम पे हमको रेलवे मिला, ना बस सिटी बस मिली. बट लास्ट 3 or 4 years से, जब से MMRDA रीजन जब से आया, जब से यहाँ पे अफोर्डेबल पोटेंशियल जो हम लोग समझते Bhiwandi सबसे अच्छा पोटेंशियल है नियर बाय थाने, और इसका ही नतीजा है कि आज महिंद्रा लाइफ स्टाइल Bhiwandi में काम कर रहा है, गोदरेज काम कर रहा है, दोस्ती ग्रुप काम कर रहा है. तो हमारे पास यहाँ पे काफ़ी बिल्डर्स जो है अपकमिंग में है, मे भी शायद हीरानंदानी का भी एक प्रोजेक्ट स्टार्ट होने वाला है कुछ मंथ में. तो Bhiwandi में पोटेंशियल काफ़ी है और Bhiwandi में लैंड्स काफ़ी है, जहाँ पे हम लोग टाउनशिप 5 to 2 acres टू अप टू 50 acres और 100 acres तक एज ऑन टूडे भी लैंड वैकेंट लैंड है. बिकॉज 2017 से पहले ऑप्शन ही नहीं था हमारे पास कि हम लोग इस एरिया में लीगल प्रोजेक्ट और रेसिडेंशियल प्रोजेक्ट करें. एंटायर एरिया इज सराउंडिंग G1 और G2 के नाम पे FSIs 0.1, 0.2, तो वहाँ पे रेसिडेंशियल करना हमारे लिए पॉसिबल नहीं था. टाटा मंत्रा आया, उन्होंने वहाँ पे रेंटल हाउसिंग में 4 FSI में काम किया. लोडा अपर थाने के नाम से आया मेगा सिटी 250 acres, बट छोटे बिल्डर्स और दूसरे बिल्डर्स जो है उनको काम करने के लिए कोई ऑप्शंस नहीं था, क्योंकि Bhiwandi सिटी वैसी इंडस्ट्री जोन था, मतलब सॉरी इंडस्ट्री एरिया था, लूम इंडस्ट्रीज थी, तो वहाँ पे लैंड बैंक काफ़ी कम था. तो हमको मूव होना था MMRDA रीजन में, बट MMRDA रीजन अब 2017 से हमारे पास जो है काफ़ी लैंड है, हम लोग वहाँ पे काफ़ी काम कर सकते हैं. और हम लोग थाना MCHI और थाना के बॉम्बे के बिल्डर्स से एक्सपेक्टेशन ये रखते हैं कि कुछ बिल्डर्स वहाँ पे और भी प्रोजेक्ट्स करें, जिसकी वजह से Bhiwandi को एक नई नज़र से लोग देखेंगे और इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलप होगा. Bhiwandi में सबसे बड़ा प्रॉब्लम है इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का. आज Bhiwandi सिटी की बात करता हूँ तो 20 years हो गए बट DP रोड का इम्प्लीमेंटेशन नहीं हुआ, ड्रेनेज सिस्टम नहीं, स्ट्रॉन्ग वाटर सिस्टम नहीं. आज STP कॉमन STP लगाना है Bhiwandi में तो उनके पास लैंड एक्वायर किया ही नहीं था, एक्विजिशन किया ही नहीं था. गार्डन को कैंसिल करके STP लग रहा है, स्कूल के प्लॉट को कैंसिल करके STP लग रहा है. ये प्रॉब्लम्स हमारे साथ Bhiwandi सिटी के साथ है. MMRDA 2007 में आई और आज 220, बट एक भी वहाँ पे उन्होंने इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के नाम पे काम नहीं किया. आज मोर देन 10 years हो गए. तो हमारा फोकस होगा बेसिक इस एजेंडा पे कि हम इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर जो बेसिक नीड है, क्योंकि रेसिडेंशियल प्रोजेक्ट हम लोग ऐसे बिल्डर अच्छे से अच्छे विथ इन द कॉम्प्लेक्स बना सकते हैं, बट उसको इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कहाँ से प्रोवाइड करेंगे. गवर्नमेंट ने अच्छा इनिशिएट किया मेट्रो ट्रेन, जो हमारे लिए सबसे इम्पोर्टेंस है, तो उस पर हम लोग काम करने वाले. रोड डिसाइड अभी कुछ वजह से पॉलिटिकली रुका हुआ है, तो हम चाहेंगे कि थाना MCHI जो वो हमको सपोर्ट करे और अपनी बात हम लोग गवर्नमेंट के पास थाना एमसी जाए के थ्रू रखे, देन एमएमआरडी के अंदर जितने भी डीपी रोड्स है उसका इम्प्लीमेंटेशन होए और हम लोग यहाँ पे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा प्रोजेक्ट्स जो अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग के उसको करने की कोशिश करेंगे और हम लोग चाहेंगे कि आप लोग हमारे लिए सपोर्ट करें और थैंक यू वेरी मच सर।
Thank you very much, sir. And I would like to invite Mr. Deepak Goradia, Mr. Boman Irani, and Mr. Satish Puranik on stage once again. We would also like to invite the Managing Committee of CREDAI MCHI Bhiwandi to join us on stage for the photo op. Mr. Chandrasekhar Gupta, Vice President, Mr. Krishna Kajengi, Vice President, Mr. Mahesh Gala, Secretary, Mr. Gajendra Kumar, Joint Secretary, Mr. Prakash Patel, Treasurer, Mr. Jitendra Jain, Joint Treasurer, the Core Committee, Mr. Jitendra Patel, Mr. Yash Jain, Mr. Lakshman Jangid, and Mr. Amit Jain. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. We now move on to the next big thing. We are proud to announce that we would be shortly launching the CREDAI MCHI mobile app. This mobile app will provide you information on the latest as well as archives of GRs, circulars, representations, research reports, court orders, webinars, real estate news, upcoming events, Directory of Members, IAS, and Ministry, all at your fingertips in one go. I would like to invite Dr. Advocate Harshul Savla, Coordinator, CREDAI MCHI, to come on stage to talk about the CREDAI MCHI mobile app.
So information is clearly the key, more so for our sector, and digitalization of that information has been the vision of our president, president-elect, as well as the secretary. I'm humbled and honored to have the opportunity to run this particular task, where the enormous plethora of activities which have been conducted by our association, whether it has been in terms of making representations, when we achieve success, the circulars that come, various meetings that are held, there are more than 30 different committees which are working on different things. So for any member at any point of time, 365 days, any minute, any information that they need pertaining to their business would be available. In addition to the business part, as an association, we also look to advocate our trade through various expos. Expose whether they are in the form of property exhibitions or whether they are in the form of procurement. Information with regards to the same also are available on the portal. And lastly, the most important part, as an association, we look to build thought leadership. CREDAI has always been the front runner in terms of real estate thought leadership, whether it is our knowledge series initiatives, whether it is the research and analytics wings, or whether it is various newsletters which look to keep our members updated. Through this app, it is our endeavor to ensure that all our members are updated on all these three fronts. I would request you all to see a 2-minute AV which will give you a glance through. The app is up and running, available on the App Store, both for the Android as well as Apple version. The 2-minute video will give you a glance through about the app. It's a OTP-driven registration process which would help everyone. All the members, their numbers are uploaded. These are the various. So we've tried to make the app infographic-driven. We would request all of you all to download this app and provide suggestions which could help us improve. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And ladies and gentlemen, we are also proud to announce the launch of CREDAI MCHI Members Guidance Cell. We would like to invite Mr. Dhaval Ajmera, Honorary Joint Secretary, CREDAI MCHI, to come on stage and to talk about the CREDAI MCHI Members Guidance Cell. Please get your hands together as Mr. Ajmera joins us on stage.
Good evening, everyone. Congratulations to the Palghar Boisar unit and Bhiwandi unit. Welcome to the CREDAI MCHI family. Congratulations, Harshul. Amazing app. I know how much efforts you have been taking over the last so many months to do this. And plethora of data, plethora of technical knowledge, super, really, really nice. So congratulations once again. Regarding this CREDAI MCHI members cell or members guidance thing, which we've initiated. Firstly, you know, I must definitely... This seed started, I remember, was sometime in last, I think 2 years back, when Honorable Chief then Chief Secretary, Mr. Ajay Mehta, had come for a CREDAI Youth Wing session here in Sofitel. And when Sir was little late, and I believe, and I know that time Vimal Bhai had given a small, you know, knowledge about how things are, what are the difficulties can happen, how, you know, what problems do we as developers face, and there are n number of issues and problems which we all go through. So from that, slowly pandemic came in. Pandemic also, I know Pritham had hosted an amazing session which was to be lasted for 1 hour, but I think voluntarily 250 people in that Zoom session were there for 2.5 hours. So that was something that really kicked in the idea. And I must really thank Deepak Bhai, our president, Mr. Baman Irani, our next elect president-elect, and Pritam, to really push this members' guidance cell and to really come up, because I know each and every one of us has some or the other issues. I don't think a real estate developer in CREDAI, MCHI, or probably a Mumbai and MMR region can go home and sleep peacefully without any problems coming out, either from the government, either from bank, either from customers, and you name the list, and the list is enormous. So I just hope that this thing has been started. Just as CREDAI MCHI, the biggest motto is togetherness and all of us being together. So this is the main theme and the main idea, where we all can come together, we all can share our issues. Any one of us who has some problems amongst us, mere ko aaj RERA ka problem hai, kal kisi ko, sales ka problem hai, kisi ko legal ka problem hai. As CREDAI MCHI, we thought that we should bring the great minds together and try and resolve every member's problem. Probably I may not be able to go to the best of the, consultant or a best of a knowledge. There are so many issues which every one of us, UDCPR, DCPR. I mean, I personally, although may have developed buildings, no. But I mean, the domain knowledge which probably Dominic has, which probably Vimalbhai has, none of us can even, think about it. So why can't I, go to Vimalbhai and speak to him, and then he can probably just help us out, and our problem, which I may be fighting it out for months together, and I can be solved in just a minute. So with this entire theme, we started that we should be brought out in expertise for each and every domain or related to our business. And then we have, requested a particular, person who is the expert knowledge or has the expert domain knowledge in that particular field to be part. And I'm very, very thankful to the entire list, which I will read down now and come to you all. And so know that we're really, really thankful as CREDAI MCHI to all the eminent participants and all the eminent guests who are willing to really help all our CREDAI MCHI members to help this resolve. I will just give you a small brief of how this will work. We will probably select a particular date or a time, and any member who has, it will be circulated amongst all our groups by email, app, and messages. Who has, let's say I'm just giving an example, there is going to be a session with DCPR 2034 with Pieta Body. So any one of us has any issues, and it will be resolved one-on-one. Every one of us, we will give a time. Just giving as an example, 10th August is the first session with DCPR 2034 with the Pieta Body. So any one of us has any issues related to DCPR 2034 can just log in or probably give their request that I would like to come in, I would like to be part of this session. And we will have individual participant will probably have 5 to 10 minute one-on-one session with the expert who can try and help them resolve their issue and then move on. So that way we are trying to make one particular session for one particular issue. For sometime it may be DCPR 2034, sometime it can be legal, sometime it can be GST, sometime it can be finance, whatever. So these kind of sessions is what we are really going to keep, and we hope and we feel that please, every one of us, we may be champions in whatever we are, but I think knowledge gained is knowledge earned. So please, please do participate, whatever the issues. Our entire aim is for you all, for every member of us, to probably resolve their issues and move forward. So I would like to call upon the expert panels who have really volunteered to be part of this entire members, CREDAI MCHI member cell. First and foremost, Mr. Shobhit Agarwal, MD Anarock. Shobhit, he is going to help us. Please to come. He is going to help us for any finance-related issues, whichever any of our members can have. We may have a one-on-one session with him. Mr. Piyush Gupta from Colliers. Mr. Sandeep Kotak. Advocate Samit Shukla for legal matters. Mr. Sudeep Malik from Khaitan & Company for Maharera matters. Mr. Rohit Jain from ELP for GST and taxation. Mr. Vijay Kumar from Juneja and Associates for labor matters. He's not there? Okay. Mr. Gopal Chiplunkar for environment and CRZ matters. He's not there? Okay. Mr. Kunal Cheda for civil aviation and defense matters. And lastly, of course, our own Mr. Vimal Bhai, Mr. Vimal Shah, for every member's personal, private issues, which probably all of us will not be able to talk talk to everyone, you know, in a field. But Vimal Bhai is always there for all of us to help us one-on-one. Yeah. I would like to request our president, Mr. Deepak Goradia, Mr. Baman Irani, and Pritam to please come on stage. Thank you all experts, thank you very, very much. It is a great honor for all of us to be part of this member cell. CREDA MCHI is really proud of every one of you all. So thank you, a big round of applause for them. I would request Vimal Bhai to please speak, because I think you have the most important topic. So I would request you to please give a glimpse and a guidance to all our members today for something.
Deepak, President Bowman, friends here, all past presidents, Poisar, Bhivandi, very pleasurable moment. Basically, the whole aim is that we want to enjoy our business. And we want to really have fun while doing business. And we don't want to remain stressed. We want to remain blissful while being in this business. Now, this looks like an elusive talks. But the whole purpose is that if we really interact with each other and don't believe that every answer I only have, but believe that answers lies with everyone. And it's always very easy to get carried away with our own thoughts while doing a business. And we always find that there is no other second way of doing this thing best. Best if it's going good, and coming out of a problem if it's going bad. And we get carried away by our own thoughts. We don't share it. We share it with the same people around us. So the same people around us give us the same solutions. And we don't realize that we are not able to come out of those problems because we are applying the same solutions. The issue is that when we really share our problems with others, not only we get different point of view, but we also get a completely different way of working. I mean, simple thing. That day I was sharing with Jayesh Bhai and everybody, that I have decided not to consume all FSI in any of my projects. I'm not going for full FSI consumption. It's a very difficult proposition. Prima facie to all Excel sheets, it looks bad. But that's how it is. So, I mean, it's just how we can share thoughts which can help. It does not apply to everyone, every situation, but every situation is different. So it's very important for all of us to really interact with each other, have guidance from each other, and work with each other and share the problems without fear that if my problem is known to X, then it will be known to the whole industry. People are, in our business, we all know that we learn to keep secret the day we entered this business. We've learned that. We don't share the information, what we do with officers, what we do with politicians, we don't share with anybody. So be sure that people are matured enough not to share your problems with others. We also learn, they also learn. I mean, we had started this exercise last year after pandemic. A lot of people came, we had an interaction with them, we gave them solutions. And sometimes you wonder that why they could not understand this simple problem. I mean, answer to their problem. I mean, why they were running around so much. And they also realized. So it's very important for all of us to really work towards it. Have such grievance cell in every unit. And have a mature person. It's like a church, there is a person whom the people go and say, and you know, that's how their sin gets washed. That's how it is said. And I don't know what gets washed, but the same thing is here, is that when you really tell to somebody, your fears get washed. The most important thing is if you get out of fear, then you are through. If you remain in fear, then you are in trouble. So that's very important. So I hope all the panelists here are exceptional and they have said other matters. So once I went through, I don't know what is other left. And I'm surely not a family counsel. So anyway, whatever it is, all of us, thanks to this panel, exceptional panel, and they are really very difficult to hold on, these people, to get them. And if Dhaval is able to get them on a particular day, it's important that we all go to them on that day, get their free advice, and have fun. Thank you.
Bimal bhai, I'll tell you what other advice means. We go to High Court. After High Court, we have to go to Supreme Court. So once we go to our experts and then they are not able to help us beyond a point, then we'll come to you for Supreme Court. So one of the things I learned, to give you an example about how members cell was formed, is that when we were at MCHI looking at the Maharera model agreement, there was a, you know, moment of super information that I got, that someone like Vimal bhai spends more than 4 months on formulating his AFS. AFS samajhte na, agreement for sale, apan jo maal bechte, Vimal bhai 4 mahine lagate usko ek clause by clause samajhne ke liye aur form karne ke liye, kyunki har project mein alag alag issues hote hai, wo cover karna zaruri hai, and he studies ki high court ya city civil court ya supreme court tak kya judgments aaye hai, एंड उसके वजह से क्या गलतियां हमने सुधारनी चाहिए अपने एग्रीमेंट में, एंड उसके वजह से काफ़ी रिलीफ मिलता है. सो ही हैज़ हेल्प्ड अस इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द महारेरा मॉडल एग्रीमेंट. हमारी तरफ से जो भी इनपुट्स गए हैं महारेरा को, इज थैंक्स टू हिज लीडरशिप. सो ऐसे छोटे छोटे चीज़ें हैं जिसमें हम लोग 10-10, 15-15 साल होने के बाद जानते हैं कि ये मिस्टेक अगर मैं पहले नहीं करता. सो देर आर सीनियर डेवलपर्स हु आर today also having court cases of 15 years back. 15 साल पहले AFS गलती से साइन किया, रॉन्ग पोजिशन डेट दी या कुछ कवर नहीं किया, उसके कोर्ट केसेस OC के बाद 15-15 साल चल रहे. तो डोंट अंडरमाइन दी इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ कोलेबरेशन, एंड मेंबर्स गाइडेंस सेल इज वन इनिशिएटिव फ्रॉम आर साइड अंडर द एजिस ऑफ द प्रेसिडेंट दैट वी आर वॉन्टिंग टू हेल्प, एंड दिस इज अ जेन्युइन एफर्ट. प्लीज मेक यूज ऑफ दिस. थैंक यू सो मच.
Thank you very much, sir. And once again, a request to all our developer members to come forward and make use of this wonderful opportunity to actively participate in this initiative, as this will help resolve most, if not all, of your queries. We now move on to the bulk buying initiative. We at CREDAI MCHI are coming up with our new big event under our IP exclusive on the 1st of September. Also, we have started exploring on bulk buying, and we are planning to launch it on the day of exclusive on the 1st of September. Our bulk buying is being led by our advisory members, Shri Nirav Parmar, Senior Vice President, Contracts and Procurement, Shapurji Palunji Real Estate, and Shri Mohan S. Upadhyay, Executive Director, Vastav Group and Co-Founder, Capsicum Global. We would like to call upon our bulk buying task owners to come on stage and shed light on the bulk buying initiative. Please get your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as we welcome on stage Mr. Upadhyay and Parmarji.
Thank you. Good evening. Respected President, sir, President-elect, all the past presidents and managing committee members, it's a great privilege to be present here and take you through the vision which we have for unveiling this bulk buying initiative with respect to that. And just to take you back, the WeProcure has been going on for last 2 years. We have netted results with that. But only thing is that, like today with the pandemic coming up, we feel that that needs to be accelerated. And as the just giving a alternative, I mean another equation is like, as we are nearing a T20 World Cup. So we thought, let us do something which can be very faster and effective. So we identified low hanging fruits with respect to the categories of material. And can you run through the presentation? So this is the entire procurement wing which is being connected with this, and the convener team on the left hand side. Yeah, it covers a gamut of all developers and their procurement team, and we have been closely working with each one of them and taking inputs from them. Next. This is the journey through the pandemic and the biznet which we have done. Now, since we are talking about digitalization of the procurement to bridge the gap between demand supply and construction activities, so we are just trying to, so as President Sir just said that it's nice to be present in physical form and meeting each other, so we are taking this opportunity and we'll just talk about the bulk buying items which we have. Yeah, in phase one, we have divided the entire exercise in two phase. Phase one, we will be taking up tiles, CP sanitary fittings, and split ACs. This is three items which we thought, because we don't want to target so many activities and then we get stuck. So this is what we have worked out, that with respect to tiles, we have broken up into categories, dimensions, and type of things, ceramics, soluble salt, double charge, GVT, PVT. Likewise, split AC units, 1 ton, 1.5 ton, 2 tons, 3 star, 5 star, and inverter. Whereas CP fittings and sanitary wares, CP faucets, we are trying to make it in with respect to number of toilets, the requirements will be there. Again, project-wise, we have categorized into low-cost, affordable housing, premium, and luxury. Then flushing systems, yeah. Yeah, we are targeting with Mumbai and MMR region for these products, and I think we will be happy to expand it to the newly two formed centers also which have been there. So we will have a broader horizon and the economy of scale will be huge for all the projects. The brands which we have identified in each of the three products are here with Jaguar, Kohler, Duravit, Grohe, Sera, Hindware, Periware, Roka, American Standard. The idea is to cater to all the segments so that once we finalize the bulk rate with them for a year, we're trying to fix it up for a year, at least up to 31st March 2022, and then offer a wide range to the developers to choose among them. And it's like we start with 9, how many of them want to continue? Some of them may drop out. So we have taken a wider range with respect to that. Yeah, next. This is the CREDAI team, MCHI team, who will be working and they will be taking up the things. And in phase two, we are planning to take up elevators, mechanized car parking systems, pre-engineered door shutters with frames and door hardwares. I would request members to provide us some suggestions or any inputs or any categories which you would like that we should include in phase one or phase two. We would be more than happy to take it, and all the collective wisdom and knowledge from your guidance will be of great help to us. And we are looking it to roll it out, I think, on the 1st of September during the exclusive event. So we are looking at a great support from you, and I think we have also circulated a sheet which will be we'll send to all the developers, and their teams can send it to us back, and simultaneously we are talking to the suppliers also. Mohan, you want to add something?
Hi, good evening, everyone. I think he has covered almost everything. So this effort, the initiative is something which wanted to talk, we've been talking for quite some time, and now it's fructified. So I would request all of you to help in getting the entire volumes together and get a best possible rate. Thank you.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. And so, ladies and gentlemen, looking forward for the 1st of September, the exclusive event. Coming up next, we have our panel discussion. MMR versus India. What will make Team MMR win? We have an eminent set of panelists joining us on stage. We would like to invite on stage Mr. Anuj Puri, Chairman Anarock. Please get your hands together as Mr. Puri joins us on stage. Mr. Ramesh Nair, Chief Executive Officer, Colliers. Mr. Shobhit Agarwal, Managing Director and CEO, Anarock Capital Advisors, Private Limited. Mr. Piyush Gupta, Managing Director, Capital Markets, Colliers. We would also like to invite on stage Mr. Deepak Goradia, President, Mr. Boman Irani, President-elect, and Mr. Mayur Shah, Past President, CREDAI MCHI. MMR versus India. What will make Team MMR win? Our moderator, ladies and gentlemen, for this panel discussion, we would like to invite Managing Director, JLL, Karan Singh Sodhi. Please get your hands together as Mr. Sodhi joins us on stage. So we are having a little get-together out here on stage, ladies and gentlemen. We are handing over this panel in the able hands of Mr. Sodhi.
Piyush, please.
अरे हम सब घर वाले हैं भाई, सब हमको जानते हैं.
सो थैंक यू MCHI CREDAI फॉर गिविंग दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मॉडरेट सेशन. वेरी एस्टीम्ड पैनलिस्ट, फर्स्टली आई लुक स्टार्ट बिफोर आई जंप इनटू द पैनल, आई लुक स्टार्ट बाय सेइंग अ बिग थैंक यू टू द एंटायर CREDAI MCHI ऑफिस बेयरर्स. आई थिंक यू आर द गाइज हु रियली फॉट विद द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इन मिड ऑफ the first lockdown, and the results are flowing. I mean, 1st June was when you officially made the statement to the CM, and then August we saw the result of the stamp duty waiver, first in the country, the state government, thanks to the efforts by MCHI CREDAI. And the results are very phenomenal. I mean, last 5 quarters, maximum sales have been Mumbai MMR region across the country, including a stellar performance of Q2 2021, which we saw 1/3 of the entire India sales coming out of Mumbai MMR. So great stuff.
But we didn't fight. We appealed, we reasoned, we begged, and we got it done.
The result matters. We're still fighting. No fighting, no fighting. Great. So with that, so I'm keeping the theme really simple. It's a very big topic, Mumbai MMR versus India. So hard to justify to that. So I'll keep it on 3 asset classes and then a common message from each person. So theme is going to be around residential, the capital flows, and the office and industrial sector class. So starting with residential, and the first question is to the developer community, starting with Mayur Bhai. I think if you look at Q2 2021, while Mumbai MMR gave one-third of sales across the country, we also saw the launch being maximum in India, the new launches. Almost 84% of the launches in Mumbai MMR were in the affordable segment. And the launches versus India data, if you look at it, it's almost 40% of the India launches coming out of Mumbai MMR region. We've seen over the last decade the buyer affinity not being towards the new launch projects, and it's only been reducing. And with the now ready-to-move-in stock depleting very fast over the last 5 quarters, what can developers do different now to get buyers attracted to the new launch projects?
So, in my opinion, I think what we have seen in last few years is a major inventory mismatch. If you look at what demand was, the supply was a little different. And that is the reason which we took a little longer time to sell whatever we had built. And particularly Mumbai, there was a huge backlog because of what we designed in 2014-15, got ready in 18, and by that time the market was different. So if we now look at what is the demand, and if we match the ticket sizes are the key now. That the what is the the target segment whom you are actually targeting, uska ticket size kya chahiye usko. So let us say if I have to talk about central suburbs of Mumbai, like Mulund and Mulund Bhandup Vikhroli. So if your two bedroom is between 1.2 crore and 1.4 crore, there is a huge demand. But if your two bedroom is going beyond 1.5 crore, the demand is very less. Similarly, if you look at in a smaller segment where we have launched in Bhandup, even Baman launch in Bhandup, the ticket size were very, very important, and the product planning also. So we launch as a new segment, new homes, which were 200 carpet studio and 330 1 BHK. So that was in demand between the 40 lakhs to 60 lakhs within Mumbai. So that is the key, in my opinion. What exactly in under construction, if you really target the segment which is ready to buy, there is a huge demand.
Mr. Bhavan, your views?
Actually, better that Anuj or Ramesh answer this question, because there's always a customer who knows what he wants and what he wants from us. But if I was to guess, I think, first of all of us developers should start using data very seriously. Start sharing data, start getting data from your fellow developers, seeing what works, because the trends are changing very, very fast. Second, I think we should make use of platforms like bulk buying, etc., to bring the cost down. Because one thing is for sure, everybody wants to buy good quality at cheaper prices. So if you saw the Maruti car when it came out, it was one of the best in its quality and still the lowest price, right? And it gave you everything that you wanted. So I think real estate should, I keep saying this time and again, should follow the automobile industry in how they do things. Third is, keep reinventing what you are building and try and cut the cycle. Now, I know it's very difficult in Mumbai, and any developer will slap me out here if I say, you need to, between concept and execution or concept and delivery, cut down your time to about 1.5 years, because by then you need to kind of cater to that market. Nobody's going to wait. These are the days of Amazon. 2 days is also too much, and they're trying to cut that time down 24 hours, right? So nobody wants to wait, and everybody wants to see value for money or certainty or whatever. And lastly, if this is possible, and I'm working on this internally at Rustamji, make home buying simple. Try and cut out all the crap. Try and cut out as many troubles as you can for the developer. Try and see that, for the buyer. Try and see that, today I can buy an automobile, for instance, at 5 clicks on my handheld phone. Why can't we do something where a customer walks in with, and now today there is so much of data available, why can't I just get all of that data to talk to each other, see whether the person is, eligible for a loan, tie up with certain banks, and see that he gets it in 24 hours, or at least gets his eligibility in 24 hours. Why can't we just make his life so simple that home buying becomes a pleasure? If I have the money, I want to go and buy it. Because A, it's a great asset. B, I might want it to use it investment. It's just, have it for my kids, and it's so simple, it's safe. With RERA, it all becomes safe, and you know, it'll become safer as time goes along. But I would say these things, I would guess, hazard a guess.
Great insights, Mr. Mohan. Deepak Bhai, you had one of the successful launches in start of this year. I'm sure we'd like to hear your insights, what worked well and what should other developers focus on.
Yes, Mayur Bhai and Bhavan explained about this, mainly the market dynamics, the research, the what profile of customer you're targeting and what type of product they expect. And that's something, and that's a dynamic. It changes every time. And the faster we do it, the quicker things are better. So what we expected, something pre-COVID, post-and the COVID time, people are now looking out a bigger house, looking out of houses with additional space. And these are the things, if it in Mumbai, if it want to change, you have to really go back to the drawing board, then go back to the committees, and then the environment, the project gets delayed by 1 year. But whatever fast we can do it, as a additional space point of view, the room, Zoom room, and all what is being required for the family to stay. For the safety of family, the houses become very, very important. So market dynamics and study what you customer would want, and in the profile of customer, what you are targeting. That is very, very important, and that really helps in the launches. Definitely, people are willing to take under construction. They're taking risk to the developers with the credibility that the possession time may be a 3 years or whatever, but they are willing to buy, put in their hard-earned money and to buy the property where the possession they will see after 3 years. These are the things which definitely has helped overall, and we need to work with the research on pricing, with the new product. Everything is important in the infrastructure of the location where you are positioning your project, so what type of profile you will get. This is very, very key important for residential per se.
Great, thank you, Deepak Bhai. Anuj sir, you're sitting on a plethora of data over the last few years, and you, I'm sure, have great analytics and insights to for developers to pick out how we can now start focusing and pushing Unity launches.
I think it's very well covered by Mayur Bhai, Baman, and Deepak Bhai. I said, look, there is sort of brain, beauty, and regulation, all three sitting in here. They've got all the inputs. I'll just say three things, Karan, to your point is, one, we're finding that brand has become very, very important. We picked up some of the projects of some developers, who were not as brand conscious, and we thought is that, as Anurag, we'll be able to really pull it through. And we've discovered is that the buyer has become very discerning. So, that is one thing that, guys, you'll have to remember is that brand has become extremely powerful. In my 25 years, I have not seen such thing. It doesn't matter. If you bring down the price by 15%, the buyer is not getting lured. I mean, this point that Bowman said is that we have RERA. When you speak with the buyer, he says, so what? It's a very interesting point. He's saying, okay, you'll put the developer into jail. So what? I'm not going to get my home. In there is, what's happened with Unitech, what's happened with Amrapali. So that's the first thing, Karan, that one has to really remember in this room is that the buyer has become very discerning. They're not necessarily looking at the price. They're not looking at Mayur Bhai as the cheapest guy. This is not what the case was. When we came out of 2008, 2009, I remember at that time, the buyer wasn't discerning. The buyer went with whoever was giving me the cheapest. Today, the buyer is saying is, well, who has the brand? I'm going to go to that. Or if you don't have a brand, then you please complete it. And then I'll come and I'll buy it. But under construction, I'm not buying for a developer who does not have that credibility. The second is, assume a financial closure without you being able to sell. I know you'll be able to sell it, and I know it's very difficult to do a financial closure without you being able to sell. But assume that you'll be not able to sell what you were able to sell, or you will not be able to sell anything if it is possible for you to do it. Do the financial closure there. Otherwise, it's just becoming very difficult on that part. And third, I like what Baman said, is that, it is the habits are changing so quickly. And, honestly, none of us in this room are really home buyers today to the capacity of what a millennial is buying. Actually, we should have a millennial sitting on the seat. He is that home buyer for us. He or she is the guy who's going to be deciding how we are going to buy, what product I want that I'm going to be buying is. And we have to look at this thing. I think it's a very difficult job. And a lot of people asked us when Shobhit and I moved out that, why are you not becoming developers? We said, we don't know what we are going to become. But one thing for sure, we know we cannot become developers. It is the most difficult job. And most difficult job, Mayur Bhai, you said, is that today you are pouring concrete in a product which you are going to sell it in 2025. You don't know how the market is going to be in 2025. How do you pour concrete in a product
you know, thinking at what the future is. It's so correct what you said is today what is selling is larger apartments. And, you know, what we were building was smaller apartment because that is what we thought is going to sell. We thought inner city will sell. Periphery is selling. We thought millennials will rent. Millennials are buying. We thought tier 2, tier 3 cities is not. Tier 1 cities are there. Tier 2, tier 3 cities are prospering. We thought, you know, plotted is one, you know, good aspect. Did not know that was a great aspect. Did not know second homes was a fantastic, you know, asset. So these are things that circumstances have changed. So you have to be very nimble-footed. So I'll say in conclusion, brand, make sure financial closure has happened. You know, don't jump into it thinking that, you know, I'll do it through the sales. And the third is that it is very, very dynamic, very quick changing. So you have to have, you have to be on the ball. I, you know, Mayur Bhai didn't touch one other point is, I mean, he's done exceptionally well of a product in Mulund on the small office. I mean, look at it. He understood what the pulse was of that product and launched Nano Office or what's
SBS.
It called?
SBS.
SBS. Small business spaces in there is. And what a dynamic thing. So he said is that it's not work from office. It's not work from home. It's work near office. And, you know, there are several people who are wanting an office within 1.5-2 kilometers of the vicinity of where they live. They can upgrade to a bigger residence. And many are upgrading to a bigger residence. But many people are saying, I cannot work in an informal environment. I cannot work from home. I do want to go to an office. I have an office in Nariman Point. I cannot go every day to a Nariman Point office. I need a 200-300 square feet office where I can leave my home and go there. I have an extra room at home where I can make it into a study, but I still cannot work from there because I need a formal office. And that's where Mayur Bhai, this has done exceptionally well, very nimble-footed, very good thought as a result of it. You know, he's done, these are what, 2 lakh square feet? How big? About 2 lakh square feet buildings.
Great, thank you, sir. Ramesh, any different insight which you have?
Karan, Anuj spoke about the brand of a project. I think more important is the brand of the city. And today, Mumbai is not just competing with 5 other large cities in India for investment. We are also competing with the global financial centers. Now, we all know what Hong Kong was going through over the last 2 years. Was there a team formed by the state government to try and see if we can get investments from Hong Kong, which is one of the biggest financial centers in the world? Can we convert that investments into India? That's one. The next thing I'm going to say may sound a little funny. I know many, but it's a well thought after point. I know many of you here may know Aditya Thackeray or Supriya Sule. If I was sitting in front of them today, I would tell them they need to go shadow a person like KTR of Hyderabad. Just spend a few weeks with him. The kind of, Anuj, you've known him. The kind of marketing he does for that city, Hyderabad city, when all the residential markets in the country today have struggled. Bombay has done well because of the stamp duty and all that. But Hyderabad is going up because that one man markets it. He gets those big companies, the Googles and Amazons and Microsofts and Facebooks. Every single big company wants to come to Hyderabad. A few years back, Hyderabad was our lowest performing office in when the Telangana issue was happening. Today, it's the best performing office of my previous company. I think we have forgotten that this city is the financial capital of the country, and we need to market that brand. We need to position that brand. That's point number one. Point number two is most of the new jobs are being created in a field called engineering R&D. And Bangalore and Hyderabad have really taken over that space. We haven't done much in spite of having the best engineers, in spite of having all the massive campuses, TCS, all that. As a city, we have kind of lost out on that. So I think the government should focus on creating jobs in the engineering R&D field and also brand the city. Today, when someone thinks of Bombay, people always complain about quality of life, cost of living, all that. How do we fix that in the minds of the customers outside? It can be fixed, right? So over a period, it can be fixed. So those are 2-3 things. If we all need to do well, investments need to come in, jobs need to be created. And that requires a lot of support of the government. And the best government to learn from right in front of us is Telangana and Hyderabad, who's done a phenomenal job around marketing their city and the state.
Thanks, Ramesh. So taking a cue from your comment, Ramesh, on investments, how do we get investments to a city? So I'll go to Shobhit and Piyush on this one. Well, if you look at the last decade, I think capital flow, be it domestic or be it international, has been more towards southern cities. If we fast forward 5 years, what's your advice to developer community here is how we can now create that buzz and get that capital attracted to our region, Mumbai member. I say our region because I'm a Mumbai boy.
You want to take a short, Piyush, or should I start?
Go ahead. Just start.
So just to give you a background, I think what we keep referring to, and I think what Karan is also saying, is foreign capital. But actually, Bombay or MMR actually has the largest share of banking money. Total investments in India, 7.5 lakh crores. MMR has 3 lakh crores. And by the way, the lowest rate of default. So you guys have done a fantastic job in safeguarding our banks, their dollars, their money. No, we don't have to worry about dollars all the time. Even rupiya ka value bahut hai. So it's good to keep our money safe. So I think we've done very well. Home loans have performed very good. I think, people on this stage and off the stage, all the developers. When we went into lockdown, I think we had the largest share of ready inventory, which moved like a cake, right? No GST, lowest stamp duty. And I think Bombay and MMR city have the lion's share of equity capital, equity market. So that market did really well. So sabke jeb mein paisa tha, stamp duty kam thi, GST laga nahi, ghar ready the, bahut maal bikas mein. So I think this is a clue that you have to continue to say, please build fast, don't stop anything that you've started. Cost of mobilization, remobilization, I don't have to tell you, you know how expensive it is. Ek bar kaam band hota hai, चालू करने में दिक्कत है एंड देन सेल करने में बहुत ज़्यादा दिक्कत होती है. सो प्लीज़ डोंट स्टॉप एनीथिंग दैट यू हैव स्टार्टेड. आई थिंक इफ़ यू डू दैट आई एम श्योर डॉलर्स विल कम इन. वन एग्जांपल इज़ टू माय लेफ्ट, ही इज़ अट्रैक्टेड अ लॉट ऑफ डॉलर्स इन थाने, ऑल इक्विटी मनी. आई हैड सेड इट बिफोर, आई मीन दीज गाइज कांट गो एनीवेयर बिकॉज बॉम्बे हैज़ द लार्जेस्ट मार्जिन, हाइएस्ट सेल्स and the best quality developers. So I don't think equity, if it wants to come in, can go anywhere but starting from Bombay in residential. I think what Karan was also referring is a lot of stock in IT offices has been built in the south. And obviously, so far, all the dollars were going in IT offices. But you'll see residential is 80% of the Indian market. Dollars have to come in. I'm very sure the largest deals will be announced very soon in Bombay. What do you, Piyush?
Yeah. So, just to add on, I think so definitely there is no dearth of capital coming to a city like Mumbai. I think only challenge is with so much of stress which we have seen in last 2 or 3 years' time. And we hear a lot from our developer friends that people are just working for investors and funds and banks, right? And today there's a situation that a lot of credit funds were charging 18%, 20% for execution capital. This situation is not good for anyone, maybe only a few lenders at this point of time. I think the key thing is, I think as a developer, we should get a capital stack right. Maybe over-leveraging or, using debt money for acquisition of land and growth. That is something, I think, critical. And equity money is available, right? At times, instead of being aggressive, but maybe having the right capital stack, I think that's one important point. Second is, I think there's a lot of focus within the Mumbai MMR or within the BMC limits to just to residential. I think we haven't seen large campus-style office developments, except CBD and maybe in the western suburbs. Like central suburbs is something which is absolutely unexplored. So, focus on office development, large developments, which will automatically, we will get capital and also fuel the residential demand.
Yeah. Karan, one point want to add that this is the only market where a developer has got listed. Not only has he got listed, he's doubled his wealth in the last 90 days. And the other listed players raised QIP. So over nearly about $600 million was raised by another listed company out of Bombay. So really, I'm telling you, money is all over the place. I don't think this city is crying for money. I mean, it has enough. You guys just need to focus on delivery, governance, and just make sure your customers are happy. I mean, they are your representatives.
And if I can just add is, it's not only attracting money, it's attracting a number of other developers from cities. So we've got Prestige who's come in here. We've got Embassy who's come in here with India Bulls. We've got RMZ who's doing a very large office development in Bombay. We've got, hopefully, Vimalbhai, DLF re-entering the Bombay market. We've got Purvankara who's here. And we've got three other guys who are at this moment in time circling and doing the rounds for Bombay. So you've got Prestige who's come recently, India Bulls who's come recently. You've got Purvankara, you've got DLF, you've got RMZ who's come in. So five big guys who have entered and three more who are circling around to see. So clearly, as you know, Shobhit and the other panelists have said, is that there is something going for the city. Otherwise, why would you leave your home city and come into this city, whether it's the margin, whether it is the ability to sell large momentum, or whether it's a mirage. Bot Bowman tells me it's a mirage, that every guy from outside thinks that there is a lot, but when you come in here, then you realize that what it is. So only time will tell what the truth is.
Great. Thank you, sir. So coming to the last sector, which is the industrial and office side, again, food for thought before I open up the question, is Mumbai MMR region, if you look at what's happening today around us, 185.7 kilometers of metro rail network being poured right now, being built, the largest, newest airport being built, the Trans Harbour Link coming along, the coastal road happening, as well as expansion of the existing rail networks. And to add it up, the best ingredient for Mumbai MMR is, if you look at these three regions as three different cities, Mumbai, Thane, Navi Mumbai, I think we compete with any other city across India. So with that in perspective, how can we get those large occupiers as well as industrial warehousing, manufacturing? I know manufacturing, I'll take it with a pinch of salt. Pune has done very well, but now I'm wearing the Mumbai hat, given I'm a Mumbai boy, so I'm being selfish. I want to know how can we attract those customers.
I'll take a shot. Please show me the land, man. लोग परेशान हो गए भिवंडी में जमीन ही नहीं मिलती है फॉर वन एकर यू हैव 200 पीपल साइनिंग अप ऑन द डे ऑफ रजिस्ट्री इट इज सो चैलेंजिंग आई एम टेलिंग यू पैसा लाइन से लगा हुआ है जमीन ही नहीं है किसी के पास विच इज क्लीन क्लियर टाइटल इफ एनीबडी रेजेस हिज हैंड आई विल सेल इट राइट आउटसाइड दिस रूम राइट सो इतनी पूरी हाँ बट बहुत जमीन है सो द बिगेस्ट टॉप एंड ये डाला टेबल मैं बस पकड़ लेता हूँ अभी इनको बट आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू गाइस भिवंडी इज 35% ऑफ द वेयर हाउसिंग मार्केट ऑफ ऑल इंडिया इज जस्ट दैट वन रोड एंड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट देयर इनफ डॉलर सर्कलिंग अराउंड पीपल वांट टू बिल्ड लार्ज वेयर हाउसेज ई कॉमर्स कंपनीज 3PL 4PL एवरीथिंग वॉन्ट्स टू गेट देयर आई थिंक द चैलेंज इज ऑन गुड क्वालिटी लैंड वेल एंटाइटल्ड गुड सर्टिफिकेट्स फॉर टाइटल्स Otherwise, please don't, because we have stories and stories when we start doing those titles, right? So it's like, I mean, this is a touchy topic. I can talk for 1 hour. But anyways.
Thank you. Mr. Baban, any views on this one?
I think I'll take off where Shobhit left. One is that there's tremendous potential at this table because of the warehousing market. There's tremendous potential at that table thanks to a port coming up over there in the Boisar Palghar region. I think if we focus, and the largest airport coming up over here, I think if we are just taking a cue from what Ramesh says, if our leadership just sells the fact that come over here, we'll give you a non-headache existence, I think the dollars will flow, right? So we need to work with the government, I guess. We need to grow areas like this. We need to have proper development around them. That's why we have two new units out here who will, get a lot of data now from us, will be able to kind of streamline themselves better. And I hope to see that they grow as the power engines for the city.
Mayur bhai?
Yeah, I agree. I think Ramesh has really put a very, very strong point. What we have is not even, it's been displayed or demonstrated, right? Even I think 10%. Even the largest infrastructure projects in the, I would say in world, it's happening in that such a small region of MMR. New Greenfield Airport, Nava Sheva Link, you know, so many hundreds of kilometers of metro projects. I mean, this is unheard anywhere in the world that such a large size projects are going on simultaneously. And that's not been pitched. And I think definitely there is even, I think, other than these two region, there is a Raigad which will be connected.
Yeah.
And thousands of acres of lands are there. So definitely Mumbai MMR region really have a very strong, and that's the thing which the others are seeing, right? Why these dollars or the developers or, you know, who want to really come in, there is a very large, long play in almost all the segments, industrial, residential, offices. If you look at Thane, Belapur, you know, what is the rate? 50, 55 rupees a square feet. I mean, this is nothing compared to even if Bangalore right now is even 60, 80 rupees a square feet. 100 rupees a square feet. So we are really underpriced even in offices,
yep,
in my opinion.
Deepak bhai, your views?
Definitely, as Mayur said, we need to project Mumbai as a, one of the very, very aggressively from a political point of view, the things we have a potential, great potential. As I was just about to say in Mayur's endorse that Thane Belapur is a big chunk of possibility. Why we can't be work to walk culture where in MIDC and surrounding area, Kalyan, Dombivli and other belt, and the prices available are much competitive compared to the Bangalore and other prices. And the knowledge point of view and the education point of view, we have a best of the institution in Mumbai and in MMR. Even there, the students' point of view, new job point of view, these are the new people who will definitely be able to work there, buy an apartment properly. The only thing is the projection point of view, Mumbai being the large metropolitan city, the most expensive city in India, that is only limited pocket of Mumbai. It's not entire Mumbai. The Mumbai MMR, where best of the infrastructure, best of the education, best of the offices available, and the opportunity to grow a large campus and offices along with a residential. This has to be rightly projected. Definitely, Mumbai can compete in all other sectors compared to anywhere.
Right. Amish, any more inputs on this?
Just a couple of points here, Karan, is when a company is looking at investing, they look at three, four things. One is the business environment, which you can't change, things like corruption and all that, which is an India-related point. Second is they look at infrastructure. Mayur bhai said we have probably the best infrastructure in this city. It's changed in the last few years, big change. Third is talent. We have the best talent in this. And fourth is aspects like social environment and all, which also Mumbai is well known for. I think Deepak ji, Boman, what you could do is, I'm sure CREDA MCHI has a certain budget, and from all these events and all which you make, if you could appoint, let's say, some of these big four firms, Deloitte, KPMG, and ENY, and all these guys, if they could do if you could appoint maybe all four different, and ask them to do studies to show that this is the most sought-after destination in the country. You don't have to pay much. They will analyze with different other cities, and then you spend a little more budget to kind of market the city, saying this is the best city. And you've seen Bangalore do it, Hyderabad see it, do it. Even states like Kerala today are trying to market Kochi, Trivandrum and all that. So I think that's required. Again, I'm coming back to that branding point again. And you have those budgets. And it doesn't cost much to do four studies to show that Mumbai has the best quality of living. Maybe we don't, but a consultant saying that will help you. We have the lowest cost of living. Things like that, you could show that Dombivli, you can buy it $4,000, right? Or your projects in Virar Vasai. So those kind of things, I think that branding is what is required.
Great. So this is, I'm sure, keep it very limited now because running out of time. Just one line answer from everybody. And the thesis of the question is, while MCHI, CREDAI, office bearers had delivered a phenomenal result in the stamp duty, but ye dil mange more. So if you have one line answer is what, you have one more opportunity to go back to the government and ask something for Mumbai MMR, what will that be?
Deepak will sum it up.
Everybody has the same answer.
Once more. Exactly, the once more definitely is there. the customer's point of view and definitely the stamp duty, but we've been definitely looking at it. Whatever the concessions we have from the premium end or the extension of the period for the time because of, again, the second wave and things are not been able to match it. So definitely our focus is right now 2-3 limited issue. We are really working on it. Extension of stamp duty, extension of, again, availing the stamp duty point of view, premium extension, and some firefighting issues which is going on, which we are trying to resolve at our level. But as an industry point of view, we, being Maharashtra, being the most dynamic, the leader among the whole India, all the states, Maharashtra will definitely, we expect that with our persuasion, with the efforts of existing government, we will be able to achieve better than what we have in the last 2020-21. So whatever the numbers we had, the quarter point of view, third and quarter will definitely beat the number of what was hit in 2021. This current 2021 will be much, much better. And we expect the good number, not only from resi, from commercial and from all aspects. Things are opening up, things should move better. And the way we are meeting today, we will have a number of things opening up and number of events happening, physical events that will really give a good life to the city again. Thank you.
Anybody else? One my answer. Anything to ask?
I want to ask, I think for all of you, like I said, I'm involved with a lot of financing. I think this city has the highest cost of construction and highest sale value. You guys need to sort out GST, man. 18% GST on cost is a killer. Input credit, mango na aap. It's difficult. So I think this city really actually is suffering because it's the highest cost of construction.
Baman is leading it. No. So basically, forget everything else. If you take a case of redevelopment in this city, right, it's so warped and Sunny can spell it out better, but I'll just try to sum it up for you. You pay. So how does redevelopment work? You go in, there's an old building, you demolish that. You build homes for those guys and then you build homes which you sell. By the time what you've sold, forget that I want input tax credit, this, that and the other. By the time what I have sold, I have covered for all my costs and I paid GST on that, right? What these guys came up with is you're doing, there's a service out there. So we want to charge you 5%, which is the rate of GST for a sold apartment, at the price of the sold apartments or at the ready reckoner rate, whichever is higher, for all those apartments that you've given as rehab. I mean, please tell me which, I would like to say, intelligent person would come up with such a theory. And we are sitting in front of them and saying, look, forget what your rules read. This is the fact. This is how you should do it. But they refuse to believe us. They refuse to accept it. And then, they put in the complexity. You'll have to go to GST Council, and then five chief ministers or five finance ministers will have to say so. I mean, seriously, get it right. Our hope, our biggest hope amongst that GST group was when Gujarat came up with redevelopment. We said, ab kuch hoga. Now everybody will listen. Because nobody's listening to us. We are probably, and they keep saying, your problem is only a Mumbai problem. It is such a small problem. I said, in numbers of apartments sold in the country, yes. In terms of value of apartments sold in the country, no. Get it right. And forget everything else. I'm saying our leadership should make a pitch for it because Mumbai has 19,000 goddamn dilapidated buildings. So these people's lives don't matter, is it? I mean, wake up for the cause, if nothing else. And we are not being able to get a time from our GST commissioner. Once I had to use some very high office to get in over there. And I'm still trying to use that same high office to get in over there again. I mean, seriously. But anyway, that was...
Sorry, yeah. So GST is again a touchy topic. So anybody else on something?
Anybody else? Or good. Great. Thank you very much, panelist. I think. Oh, my. Okay.
Nothing great, but the office market... If Mumbai need to be revived, we really need the offices to be open 100%. Yeah. I'm not sure. I was last week in Ahmedabad. Everything 100% open. Are school chalu ho gaya Ahmedabad mein. Where are we? I mean, I don't know why we are so bogged down and no train, nothing, and that is actually hurting the city the most, where the commercial activity is been curtailed, restaurants are not opened. I mean, abhi theek hai, abhi sabko khud ka risk lene do.
I know you'll sum it up, but I want to just tell everybody out here, look at the wide variety of inputs that we got in this one evening. I'm going to take this recording and show it to all my leadership at the office and just tell them we need to start sharing more, thinking differently, imbibing, learning from people, and then executing well. And let's do one thing. I think you mentioned Brand Mumbai, or you mentioned whatever, Brand Mumbai. Let's all build in such a way that a customer, at least after he gets his home, says, ah, zindagi ban gai. Let us all focus on that very simple task of building well. Let us all do that.
Great summary. Perfect. Thank you very much, panelists, and it was a pleasure hosting you. I'll share the notes with Preetam and the team. Thank you.
Can we have a photograph with the panelists, please? Yeah? The moderator too.
So we have the panelists up here on stage. MMR versus India, what will make Team MMR win? Mr. Anuj Puri, Chairman, Anarock. Mr. Ramesh Nair, Chief Executive Officer, Colliers. Mr. Shobhit Agarwal, Managing Director and CEO, Anarock Capital Advisors Private Limited. Mr. Piyush Gupta, Managing Director, Capital Markets, Colliers. And our CREDAI MCHI team. Can we have a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, also for our moderator, Mr. Karan Singh Sodhi. And now, we would like to invite the young and new age entrepreneur, our secretary of CREDAI MCHI, Mr. Preetam Chivukula, to deliver the word of thanks. Please get your hands together for Mr. Chivukula.
You wrote this script?
No, I didn't write. Yeah. He's laughing, so they call me young. That's why I'm going to wear specs. Nain bhai, have you joined the army or what? Or are you going to go and scare all the flamingos away from the forest? You're the man on the job. Deepak bhai, we don't have to worry. Nain bhai has taken up the job. Flamingo matter solved. But Nain bhai, what is the secret of this uniform? You will have to tell all of us, because we are feeling very awkward wearing what we are wearing right now. So he is giving NOC. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Thank you so much. Thank you, Everest. I'm here to give the vote of thanks for everyone, and I'm going to be standing literally between Botal and Khana. But I'd like to just quickly call Sachin Mirani, our outgoing secretary of Thane MCHI. He'd like to say one quick word.
Good evening, everyone. I would just like to invite all the committee members for the change of guard on 7th of August in Thane. We have our new president, Mr. Jitu Mehta, taking over. I request all committee members to do come. Invites would be already shared, but it's a personal request to everyone to do attend. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. This job, this team has done a wonderful job in Thane. As far as vote of thanks concerned, I'll start with my beloved team in CREDAI MCHI. They work very, very, very hard to put up this great show. Thank you, team, for doing this wonderful job. As always, perfectly delivered. Thank you, everyone, for that. I'd like to thank both the units for making it all the way from your respective offices and homes all the way to Bombay. Thank you. All the best. And we hope that we can truly work together and make a difference to your area. You already have some deals happening, I can see. But truly, once you are in the system, you'll realize that there is a lot of synergies, and that will, you know, really give a spurt to the region there. I'd also like to thank all our office bearers from CREDAI MCHI who've taken their time out and come. I'd also special thanks to the member guidance cell professionals who've also taken time out of their busy schedule today. I'm not taking names, all our friends here. So thanks to them. And because they are coming, I got permission to serve liquor today. So thank you, special that. And thank you, everyone else in the support team and the production team. Thank you so much. Good night.